Hello, brothers and sisters, and anybody listening. Michael, humble seeker of truth for rapture and apocalypse, the end from the beginning, verily. So this is going to be a little different in that I don't have any notes. All I have is charts, and so there's going to be a lot of... that, and I guess that's not all that different if you've been following along, but it might be a little worse than normal. I need to do it, at least I feel like I need to, because if I don't, I have to find the time to put it all into notes, and I'm challenged right now. And so it's been a little while since I've done a video, and Father has shown more just absolutely breathtakingly amazing, beautiful stuff. And I want to share it with you. So it's bursting out of me. So bear with me, and let's do it. Little bit of review, little new. You might have guessed that. A lot new, actually. So let's start with this. So we looked at this last time, and these are prime numbers starting after 53. So 59, 61, 67, 71, 73, and 79. It is six primes. Okay, so I know I made the point, I believe, but I want to make it better. So this segment of prime numbers is a story in itself, and I'm reviewing it because as we go, we're going to look at a lot of numbers once again. You might have guessed that from Strong's especially. And so, but I want you to watch for these numbers because they tell a story, a true story, and one that is about to come to fruition. And so... just this in itself, okay, 59 bridges us from the 53 to 61 is verily, verily I say unto thee. When Israel is 67, the last week of Daniel will begin, and the 7-7s count began in 1967. 6-7-1967, in case you missed it, that equals 153 big fish. The 20th prime is 71. When Israel is 71, Jacob's trouble is going to begin. Okay, 4 years into the last week of Daniel. That brings us to 73 and then 79. And these two together equal 152 because 152 big fish of the 153, or 99 of the lost sheep, are going home to be with the Lord. Yeah, yep. So, again, verily I say unto thee, last week of Daniel begins in 67. When Israel is 67, we know that God in Psalm 90 gave us two parameters to apply our hearts unto wisdom by learning to number the days and how he's numbered them. 1,000 years becomes yesterday and is a watch in the night. That was January 21st, 2000. And then Israel's age. Okay, all in Psalm 90, and I know that's mega review. 73, a good example of that is 2 Timothy 4, verse 7, I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course or my race. Well, what do you mean finished it? Finished it. Because going home, okay, He declared the end from the beginning and throughout ancient times. Well, do you know that before he created man, he put the sun, moon, and stars in the heavens? And we know from Scripture that he numbered them. They're his numbers. Okay, they're his prime numbers. They're all his numbers. It's just a matter of applying our hearts unto wisdom. How's he using them? What's he saying with them? We don't just look at numbers and not Scripture. We always start with the God of Word, the Word of God. And the God of Word. It's God's Word. And they're His words. They're His numbers. Okay? And so, finished my race. Because you're in the 99 sheep, the 152 of the 153 big fish. This 71, when Israel was 71, is the 20th prime number. We know 20 times full circle, 360 day years is 7,200. And from when 1,000 years became as yesterday and as watch in the night, plus 7,200 days brings us exactly to the Day of Atonement, 2019, where God says he will appear over the mercy seat. Okay, tied to the Day of Atonement. And that word appear is Strong's, number 7,200. It's awesomely amazing. We saw in Jeremiah 10:3 where this is tied to the rituals of Christmas. And what's at the heart of it is what we're considering. Not somebody celebrating the Lord or feeling closer during Christmas. I'm not trying to pick on that. It's how did he get there? He was born September 11th, 3 BC. How did he get moved to December 25th? And who did it? And why? Okay, and God speaks about it. And this is one of the places. The traditions of the people are vain. Of the people, 5971, tying to this story, or this part of how he's declaring what's going to happen, what has happened, what's going to happen, our vein is 73 times. It's right there in a verse. Okay? So before we really dive into scripture and into Strong's, I want to show you something, okay? So we just talked about 72 times 360, 7,200. 72 equals 71. Well, that doesn't sound right, I know, but I mean it in light of Israel's age, okay? If it's, we use 360-day full circles years, they're 72 since they became a state May 14th, 1948. If we use Hebrew years or Gregorian, they're 71. So let's take a closer look at that because it is also quite amazing, at least to me. Okay, now this is where I'm going to really have to... So from May 14th, 1948 to December 26th, a day we've seen so many things tied to, we have a full annual eclipse, we have the 1200th lunation, new moon, December 26th, 2019, it's 26,000, 26 is Yahweh, Gematria. It's 26,158 days. Well, that's 71 years, 7 months, and 12 days. And if you've, again, been following along, I'll try not to keep saying that over and over, but then again, maybe I will. 71 years, Israel 71. 7 months. 7 is spiritual completion and perfection and represents 7 seals for the 152 sheep. 7 trumpets for the lost sheep. 12, full circle on the menorah, family going home, family added, okay? And if you don't know what that means, message me, I'll send you to a different video. Strong's number 71 is to lead, carry, or to bring. Glory to God. Let's look at a place that's used, John 10:16. Now this is the Good Shepherd section, okay? Verse 15, as the Father knows me, even so I know the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep, and thank God that he did. And other sheep I have, which are not of this fold, Now, when's he saying this? He's saying this to the Jews that believe. Okay, other sheep I have that are not of this fold. Well, the new man is not made yet, made of Jew and Gentile, a new creation in Christ, because he hasn't accomplished his work yet and shed forth the Holy Spirit yet. And other sheep I have which are not of this fold, them also I must bring, and they shall hear my voice. They shall hear my voice. Strong 71. You're going to see he declares this plan. We've seen it a ton of ways. We're going to see it more. And it's so cool. It's just so cool. Okay. It's used 69 times. You remember Arcturus, a representation of Jesus Christ in the heavens. Coordinates 14, 15, 40. And then 2019, 10, verdict rendered, 56. Grace man, innocent in the blood of the Lamb. But that 14, 15, 40 is 69. It's used 69 times. Do you understand? Strong 71, marking out Israel being 71, which is to bring carry, is used 69 times. Strong 69 is to be wakeful, to be awake and watching. If we're alive and remain at the coming of the Lord, we haven't fallen asleep in Christ, we're awake. Because we make these connections, we see these beautiful declarations. So, 26,158 days divided by 360 is 72.6611. 72.6611 years. 72, we just saw. 72 times 360 is 7200. I didn't say that right. 72, they're 72 years old, prophetic years. 66, that's a representation of what's coming. We know 666 is as well. But from Daniel 3, 1 or 2-ish, the statue, figurative for the one that's going to be built anytime, soon as we're gone. 60 feet tall, 6 feet wide, and in that way 66 represents that. 11 is destroying angel. But notice also what we have. We have 61 in 61. Verily, verily, I say unto thee. Wow. You might have heard some talk about the full moon. 12-12. I cut myself off there. 12-12 at 12-12, people are talking about. Well, that depends what time zone you're in. That's cool. But it's even cooler. So the 12-12, we know 12 represents full circle on the menorah. 12-12 like that, you know what that colon is? It's a river. Guy on this side, guy on that side. Oh, yeah. But guess what time it is in Jerusalem? It's at 7:12. Well, interestingly, that's exactly the point of greatest eclipse. From the end of the 19-year cycle that started January 21st, 2000, to January 21st, supermoon to supermoon, Tubishvat to Tubishvat, God marking out 2019. Oh, yeah. January 21st, 2019, 7th of the 7th tetrad. 7th blood moon of the 7th tetrad, end of the 19-year cycle. point of greatest eclipse, 7:12. So God again providing warning and providing means of us watching, seeing him in it. Oh, it gets better. So I don't know, screenshot, if you care to. Okay. New moon on 12/26. So this is pointing forward. New moon 12/26/19 is at 7:13. Okay. We've looked at that several ways. I'm not going to completely review it. Astronomical twilight. We haven't talked about twilights for a while. So just like God's harvest model, there's 3 points in time. First fruits, a couple thousand years ago. Main harvest, 99 sheep, bride of Christ. Law, beginning of Jacob's trouble. Soon as we're gone. Law, sheep, end of Jacob's trouble. No end of confusion when you don't discern God's harvest model. And he doesn't leave it just at the physical harvest. He declares it in his name. Behold the hand, behold the nail. Four nails, three gatherings, two hands at the end from the beginning. Four nails, Christ was the wave sheaf. Then first fruits, same day, a couple thousand years ago. Matthew 27, 51, 2, 3. The twilights, God made them to reflect those 3 points in time. Remember, they went to the tomb first thing in the morning, about sunrise. Well, before the sun actually rises, there's 3 periods of twilight in between night and day. And that day it shall not be night nor day. Does that point to twilight? Maybe. Astronomical twilight, when the sun is 18 degrees below the horizon, 3 vavs. Vav is 6, it's a nail. In Hebrew, it's a picture of a nail. Ancient Hebrew. 3 of them, 18, because it represents both things that are coming. The one true God's Son, Jesus Christ, or the false Christ, Satan in the face of. 18 degrees, astronomical twilight, sun below the horizon. 12 degrees, nautical twilight. 6 degrees, civil twilight. Now look at this. On December 26th, astronomical twilight. Hey, I gotta call you back. So I see I have, sorry about that. I see I have a mistake here. This is, it's 509 to 509, not 609. It is 12 hours. Nautical twilight, 539 to 539. 12 hours. What? Solar noon, 11:39. That's a lot of 39s, isn't it? Well, what a strong 39. 5:39 is to confirm. What? And to believe. That's beautiful. See, it's at the time he made it at. He made it 12 hours, and he made it 5:39 to 5:39. Nautical twilight, the middle one for the middle harvest as a signpost? Absolutely. Does it have to be that day? Well, we know that in the past we've seen cool things with twilights. Doesn't have to. We don't know the day and hour, but worthy of note. Doesn't mean it couldn't be that day, that's for sure. Especially with the 15 different things we've seen point to it. December 26, 2000, 19 is what we're talking about. 539, to confirm or believe. Strong's 39 is holy place, sanctuary. We've finished our race. Going to the holy place. It's also Father is El. Elohim of hosts. And that's used twice. Couple places this Strong's 39 is used as holy place or sanctuary. Let's take a look at Hebrews 10 verse 19. Verdict rendered, the grace men innocent in the blood of the Lamb. 2019, having therefore, brethren, boldness through the grace that is in Christ. Having therefore, brethren, boldness to enter into the holiest. I hope I'm not making this confusing. Having therefore, brethren, boldness to enter into the holiest by the blood of Jesus. Saved, washed clean in the blood of the Lamb. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus. The day length is 10. Verdict rendered, full circle in Christ for the heirs, the offspring. It's 10:04:52 is the day length on December 26th, 2019. Civil twilight, the last one, is from 6:10. So understand this, there's a twilight in the morning and a twilight in the evening. So when we look at these, you know, 12 hours, well, I mean, the sun doesn't stay below the horizon for 12 hours. There's a starting place below the horizon and an ending place after it goes down at night. Okay? So we have this range, beginning and ending. 6:10 to 5:08 is 10 hours, 58 minutes, 58 Strong's in assembly. Glory to God. All right, bearings. Pop our prime number story back up for a minute. We saw 5971, how it ties in. Is there any place else in the Word of God that we can see amazement of our Father? Yeah. Of course there is, or I wouldn't ask. It happens to be in Daniel 12. Let's go to Daniel 12. Visit our beloved brother Daniel. We're going to see it come up as we go. I'm just going to start in 12:1. Sorry. Got chair issues. Let's read verse 1. And at that time shall Michael stand up, the great prince which stands for the children of thy people. You guys gotta just think I'm nutty. And at that time Michael shall stand up, the great prince which stands for the children of thy people, and there shall be a time of trouble such as never was since there was a nation, even to that same time. From that time to that same time is what that means. And at that time thy people shall be delivered, every one that shall be found written in the book. So let's take a look at this in Strong's and see if we can see anything cool. Okay. So I'm going to put it up for a minute, then I'm going to have to look at it back and forth. Daniel 12:1. And at that time, 6256, it's 25, which is interesting with all the stuff we've seen about Christmas in past videos. In 66, which we've already talked about. That great prince, at that time, the great prince is Strong's 1419. 14 for seven seals, seven trumpets. Michael is going to stand up. Satan and his angels get cast out of heaven, and Jacob's trouble begins. Okay. It's also 41 in 19. Strong's 41 is holiness. 19, of course, 2019. There shall be 1961. 2019, verily I say unto thee. And leads us back to our story in the primes. A time, same thing, 6256. Since as never was. You guys, I could literally take every single word. I don't perfectly understand every single number, but many of them. We're going to be awash in numbers just as is. I literally could have it three, every single verse almost. And there's always something there. It's, do we understand it? Okay. Such as never was. A time of trouble such as never was is 1471. So these two parameters once again coming together. 19, 2019, and then Israel's age. The 14 ever pointing to seven seals, seven trumpets. So at seven seals, beginning seven trumpets. At least in these instances. And then, and at that time thy people shall be delivered, every one that shall be found written in the book. In the book is 5612. 5612. 56 grace man, full circle on the menorah. I am not making this stuff up, guys. I couldn't ever make sense of it if it wasn't him. Daniel 12:3. I skip to, again, to not have too many numbers. Daniel 12:3. And they that be wise, oh, is this beautiful. It's 79:19. They that be wise. Here's our prime story. Verily I say unto thee. Last week of Daniel starts. Oh, we're in Daniel, aren't we? When Israel 67. 99 sheep when they're 71. Beginning of Jacob's trouble. And then shown by this. And this 79. By the way, we looked at this 7200. To the Day of Atonement from January 21st, 2000, it's 79 days to December 26th from this day that God has marked out. They that be wise, oh, by the way, wise, simple gematria, is 56 because it's the grace men that are wise because they've accepted the free gift of salvation through Jesus Christ. Glory to God. And they shall shine as the brightness of the firmament. That is used 17 times. We've talked about 17 a lot. I'm going to leave that right now. God made the earth ring like a bell every 17 seconds for 1,200 seconds. Tying to the 1,200th lunation, I believe. pointing to it. This is 10 plus 7. I said I wasn't going to cover it, and I am. Court in session, verdict rendered, seven seals. Same thing at the end. Court in session, verdict rendered, seven trumpets. So 17 can represent one, the other, or both. And here it represents both. The firmament is 75-49. The 49, once again, is 7 times 7. 7 seals, 7 trumpets. everything culminates in 2023 when Israel is 75. Now look, it's also 54 in 79. We just looked at the 79 days from atonement to December 26. We saw it in the prime story. 54, so it's 54 in 79. 54 means Father is the great one. Oh, and is he? And they that turn many. Sorry, this one's flimsy. We do what we can with what we have. It is 7227, which is 22 in 77. In 2022, after seven seals and seven trumpets, the lost sheep will go home and be home and complete the family. Back to non-flimsy charts, so that's good news. Okay, this is just going to get better, you guys. I am going to drop a big diamond on you. Very soon, at the end of this. Try to always save. And you know what? He just orders it. Daniel 12:4. But thou, O Daniel, do you know that Daniel is 1840? It's also 1841. That's another part of the story. Anyway, 1840 is 184 times 10. God gave Daniel these visions, sent Gabriel to explain them. How'd you like to have an angel come and explain the word to you? Well, I got one better for you. We're going to be learning at the feet of the Master, our Lord Jesus Christ, the teacher. Wow, can you imagine it? So very soon now. Be strong in the Lord. 1840, 184 times 10, meaning sealed up to Daniel. At the end, he's like, you know, I just still totally don't get it. Well, that's okay. The meaning sealed up till the end times. Well, God's got he works through people. He gives revelation to people. He gives wisdom to people. And that's just how he's always done it. So he's going to declare the end from the beginning, and he's going to open it up in the end times, which we are in, and he has. And if you don't know why the 184 matters, I'm not going to get into it. But thou, O Daniel, let's read verse 4. But thou, O Daniel, shut up the words and seal the book, even to the time of the end. Many shall run to and fro, and knowledge shall be increased. Even until the time of the end, there's that time again. That's that 62:56. Of the end, sealed up to the time of the end. It's 70:93. Okay, we know Israel turned 70, and God's been revealing stuff fast and furious ever since. But look what we also have. It's full circle divine order in 73. We just talked about 73. It's in the prime story. I have finished my race. And then 79 days from atonement to December 26th. Worthy of note. Shall run to and fro is 77:51. It's in between the seven seals and the seven trumpets that they're running to and fro. Knowledge shall be increased. Well, the word of God's going to be scarce. So this one stumps me a little. Let's come back to it. 51 is the walls of the temple, which are the believers. Knowledge is 1847, which is 184.7 spiritual completion and perfection times 10. Shall be increased 7235. It's 23 and 75. Do you understand the significance of that? It ties both parameters together in 2023 when Israel is 75. This culminates, the earth gets cleansed, and then New Jerusalem will be with men, new heaven, new earth. Okay? This shall be increased is used 226 times. Now, if you get this tie-in, it's absolutely mammoth. Strong's 226 is the same thing in Genesis 1:14. He put the sun and moon and stars for signs and seasons. And this is Strong's 226 is that signs. It literally means signals. It's used 79 times. And here it's tied to this. It's absolutely huge. You see the little smiley face here? I felt like I really needed to add some artwork because this stuff is a little plain. And that's as good as it gets from me. And my art is better than my singing. Daniel 12:5. Let's read it. Then I, Daniel, looked, and behold, there stood other two. Oh, this is so cool, you guys. Gosh, I... You got to understand, I know where we're going, and sometimes it overwhelms me before I get there, so you might be going, what is he worked up about? Hopefully you get it after the fact, if not before. Then I, Daniel, looked, and behold, there stood other two, the one on this side of the bank of the river and the other on that side of the bank of the river. We know this is a picture. We've seen it in other places in the Word and more than a couple. 99 sheep go home. They're on that side of the river. Lost sheep are on this side of the river. Okay. Daniel 12:5. Daniel, once again, 1840. Looked and behold, Strong's 7200. The one on this side and the one on that side. Look at this. It's Strong's 259, okay? It's used 952 times. Do you know why? Because it's a river. It's a reflection. Can you see it? It's a reflection. It is. Let's go to 2 Corinthians 3:18. But we all with open face, unveiled face, beholding as in a glass, or as in a mirror, or as in a river. The glory of the Lord, but we all with unveiled face, beholding as in a glass the glory of the Lord, are changed into the same image. From glory to glory. This happens to be, that unveiled happens to be Strong's 343. Now that ties, it's 343 days from January 21st, 2019, the end, the ultimate marker, to the eighth day of Hanukkah. We're looking a lot at the 26th, but if that's not the day, I'll tell you that that stretch between the fifth and eighth day of Hanukkah, super It's more high watch than anything I've ever seen, and of course it is, because we have the most hindsight, so I guess it'd be, that goes without saying, but there it is. I said it anyway. All right, this is super, super cool. Hopefully you see that. And where it is, look and behold, the one on this side and the one on that side. It's twice in this verse of scripture. And it shows the river. Okay. On this side is, it's 2008, but it's also 200 and the number 8. What happens to be 200 days from the day of Pentecost to December 26th. 8 is new beginning. Worthy of note. It's also 200 pomegranates on each pillar of the temple. Guy on this side, guy on that side. Those are the two pillars. 200 pomegranates on each one. It's used 14 times. 7 seals, 99 sheep. 7 trumpets, lost sheep. 2 pillars. Only God could do this. Only God could even conceive it, let alone. Between this being put together over a couple thousand years by 60 some authors, I think, and then into Strong's, based on the order he put in here, it is absolutely breathtaking and can only be the Creator God. Of the bank, one on this side of the bank of the river is 8193. It's 19 in 83. 2019, 83, 84 both mean pinions. Oh, and they both mean confusion, I believe. They mean the same thing, which is so phenomenal in itself, because the days of Hanukkah go evening to evening, so it covers 2 days. And the 8th day of Hanukkah is both the 83rd and 84th day. Pinions means wings. Given 2 wings of a great eagle. Oh, it's used 176 times. Well, that brings us back to Psalm 119. 19th letter at in Psalm, in the 19th book of the Bible, Psalm 119, in the 19th letter, a circle with a line through it showing exactly what we're talking about. The line is the river, and the ark is an ark, and there's 2 of them, 99 sheep, lost sheep. I know I'm beating it up, but I'm doing what I'm supposed to do, and I lost my train of thought. Of the bank of the river, 176 times in the 19th book, in Psalm 119. It ends with the 19th letter, we just talked about, ends with verse 152, the only one in the entire Word of God. Because in 2019, 152 sheep are home. Covered that a bunch. It ends with verse 176. That's the last verse in Psalms 119. I have gone astray. Like a lost sheep. Immensely beautiful. And seeing it tied to this. To the. Of the bank. Of the river. Of the firmament. Of the barrier. Guy on this side. Guy on that side. 99 on that side. Guy on this side. 152 up there. One down here. The 153rd. Of the river. 2975. 75, once again, everything wraps up when Israel is 75. River, it's translated into river 53 times, because 53 is, it's Yahweh and his family. It's the Father and the Son's head and body. Which, by the way, is also 55. It just depends whether you add it or you write it. 29. Back to Arcturus. Both coordinates of Arcturus. 14, 15, 40. 19, 10, 56. They both, it's 29 and 40, 29 and 56. If you add the first two coordinates. Seems like not random. By the way, Strong's, here's the Arcturus stuff. Strong's 29 means Yah is my father. The God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. And our God and Father. That's why it's 53 times. The Father and his family.
Yah is my father.
I'm having fun. I don't know about you guys. Okay. We're going to look at one verse and then a couple verses in Genesis. The whole title of the video is End from the Beginning. Well, we tied that to the signs in the heavens. That's beginning. What about the beginning of the Word of God? Well, let's start in the verse that declares that where God says he declares himself as God. By declaring the end from the beginning and from ancient times things that are not yet done, because he's the only one that can do it. Oh my gosh, this is awesomely beautiful. Isaiah 46:10. Let's go there. Let's read it. I love you guys. Thanks for watching with me. What a joy and privilege it is to have you watching for our Lord with me. Verse 9, Isaiah 46, remember the former things of old, for I am God and there is none else. I am God and there is none like me. Declaring the end from the beginning, verse 10. And from ancient times, the things that are not yet done, saying, my counsel shall stand and I will do all my pleasure. Declaring the end. Oh, that's Strong's 319, which is both 31 and 19. Okay. 31 is a message. 19, I know you don't need me to say it, but I'm going to anyway. 2019. Declaring the end from the beginning. And he does it numerically as well as scripturally as well as celestially. Oh, guess what? It's used 61 times. Verily I say unto thee. That is off the chart. Declaring the end from the beginning. Strong 72, 25. It's 22 in 75. The lost sheep go home when Israel's 74. And everything finishes up when they're 75. So 22, father and his family, all home in New Jerusalem when Israel is 75. Declared the end. That's the end. That's the beginning of the millennial reign. That's the end of the age. Declared the end from the beginning. From the beginning. 72:25. Oh, it's 51 times. Walls of the temple complete. Father of the wall. Now, where else, of course? Well, what's the beginning of the Word of God? Genesis 1. Let's go there. In the beginning, God created heaven and earth. You might have saw this as I put it up here. Genesis 1:1 in the beginning. He declared the end from the beginning. So let's go there in the beginning. Oh, it's that same number, 7225, which also, by the way, is Israel 72 prophetically does the 25 point to the judgment that is being brought because of everything that's behind Christmas. Just the worst idolatry imaginable. I don't even want to speak of it. It makes me sick. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth was without form and void. Now, according to Strong's Concordance, that word was is literally became. And if you get deep into the language, there was no verb that is was, but that's how God says it. So, but it is literally became. Well, that's interesting as a figure, because again, that was at the beginning, but it's a figure. He declared the end from the beginning, and he does it in figures, and the numbers are the roadmap to understanding the figures. Perfect example. Was is became, because the earth is about to become without form and void in light of. It's going to be completely different. A third of the sun, moon, and stars gone. A third of basically everything on earth, including people. It'd be a good time to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior if you haven't. Romans 10, 9 and 10. Was, became. It's 1961. Declares the end 3:19, 61 times. Now we have the earth's become and void 2019. Verily I say unto thee. Oh, and it's 75 times, because when Israel's 75, God's gonna remake heaven and earth. It's amazing. Genesis 1:3. And God said, let there be light, and there was light. Let there be. 1961? What we're seeing here, even though we see another separation with sun, moon, and stars, and a separation of darkness in the fourth day, this is first day. And it is a separation of light and darkness. Let there be 1961. Amazing. Light. Strong's 216. It's 1 in 26. Because God is one. Father, and he's Yahweh 26. It's used 123 times, because in 2023, the family, the 100 sheep, are going to be home. It's over and over and over and over. Any important prophetic place you go in the Word where there's going to be a picture of the end from the beginning, you're going to see the same thing, the same kinds of numbers, because they're his numbers and they declare what he made them declare. It's just, do you understand? And if you don't, it's greatly my fault. Genesis 1:4. And God saw the light, that it was good, and God divided the light from the darkness. That's exactly what he's going to do in 2019. When the 99 sheep go home and Satan and his angels cast out of heaven, 99 sheep, bride of Christ, first trumpet, up, darkness. And God saw, verse 4, and God saw the light, that it was good. 7,200. His parameter, 1,000 years yesterday, and as a watch, January 21st, 2000, 7,200 days to Judgment Day, the Day of Atonement verdict rendered. Then we've seen 79 days to the 26th, 83-84 to the 8th day of Hanukkah. Just sharing what I see. Verse 5. And God called the light day, and the darkness he called night, and the evening and the morning were the first day. Called is 7121, which is 71. 21, 7 seals, 7 trumpets, 7 bowls. But it's also, and more importantly, it's 12 in 71. Full circle in 71. And he puts it there twice. And the evening and the morning were the first. It's Strong's 259. Used 952 times. He declared the end from the beginning. He then gave it to Daniel. It's absolutely amazing. Here's the river. Here's the firmament. Guy on this side, guy on that side. 99 sheep going to be on that side. And the 952, 9 is divine order for the heirs, the offspring, starting with the 99 sheep. If you understand this, I can't imagine that you're not super blessed. I just can't even fathom it. I know that I am. I wish I had a better way of delivering it, but I don't. And so we do what we can with what we have. Glory to God in the highest. Glory to his Son, Jesus the Christ. God bless you.